Okay, so if we continue this idea that environmental accounting can help us to prevent disasters, but also to kind of change the mindset of organizations into a more environmental friendly mindset, we will like to implement this kind of KPIs, the key performance indicators, on the management control systems of every organization. So the idea of this, like the slide says, is to create these indicators so we can kind of shape the organization and that the organization is worried about fulfilling these indicators. So this is kind of a way to push everyone in the organization to fulfill some things that are related to environment. And some examples for those KPIs are here. And I think you should take note of this because this will help you when you complete your activity, also when you do the case study of this partial, and also in the final project when we are going to suggest improvements on environmental accounting and for sustainability accounting in general to an organization. These are important KPIs that are not that, how can I say, like not that popular, or they're not that traditional in accounting nowadays, but you can use this to propose a change. So for example, we have efficient utilization of scarce material, natural resources, including power, energy, and material consumption. So this is something important, right? Like if you are using natural resources, maybe you want to account for this and you want to show off that you are doing well. Also about this, like how many of your materials are recycled materials, that's also something interesting that you would like to report. Are you producing environmentally safer products? That's also something important, like what percentage of your total production is environmentally safe? So that's kind of some KPIs that we can use to show in accounting terms what we are doing. I know that maybe this sounds a bit quantitative, but you can make it also qualitative. Like for example, what about this, right? Like providing insurance claims for negligent or inappropriate use, disposal, or transport of hazard material. So this is like, are you being sued for this kind of things? Have you avoided suits about this? So that's kind of something that you can build on. It seems like a way to show that you are doing well in terms of environmental accounting. And also a big topic in environment accounting is that we need to consider issues about climate change, right? So climate risk disclosure is a huge thing in environmental accounting. So here are some things that a study from the Environmental Defense Fund from the US did, and this is their finding from their report. And they say that in any organization should report, because the moment that they did this 10 years ago, firms in the US were not reporting efficiently or well enough or good enough in terms of climate change. And they suggested that organizations should include these five things, right? So they suggest that if you are going to report on sustainability and on environmental issues, you should consider these five things in terms of climate risk disclosure. So it talks about the executive leadership. So you need to report what's the strategy in terms of climate risk. Then business drivers that are also transmitted from strategy to operations. How are business executives committed to that strategy? What investments are you doing to improve climate change issues? Here it says despite regulatory uncertainty, because we're going to talk about this. Like I think I said in the last video that even though you are not forced, you should kind of do an effort in this thing. And also how transparent is the reporting in terms of climate change issues? So those are the five things that one organization should focus when reporting in climate risk. So in the next video, we'll talk about what's going on in the world, where are the kind of the trends that are in the world, and how can we use these trends to report in terms of environmental accounting.